Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our biology from 4 lesson 7, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on genetics and the subtopic are the practical applications of genetics. Remember that there are a wide variety of the practical applications of genetics, but here we are going to be specific. But before that, we are going to have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to give two circumstances under which genetics is applied. We can do something on genetic engineering, whereby we are saying this deals with the identification of a desirable gene, altering, isolating and transferring it from one living organism to another. Through genetic engineering, it is now possible to make use of rapidly reproducing living organisms such as bacteria and fungi in the production of useful life-saving substances. These substances include hormones like insulin, somatotrophin, antibiotics, interferons, vaccines, and what we call vitamins. Genetic engineering has made it possible to produce genetically modified organisms, which actually they are known as the GMOs, which have resulted in increased production in crops and domestic animals. Genetic engineering has been applied in several fields, whereby the field include farming and medicine. So let us now look at genetic engineering in farming, whereby we can see genetic material of the organisms is altered to achieve desired characteristics in a shorter time than it would be possible through the normal crossing. Remember, these are what we call the the genetically modified, for example, you can have maize. Genetically modified maize and soya beans have been produced which have resistance against insect pests. This has been achieved by inserting the genes that confer the resistance from a bacterium, that is the Bacillus thuringiensis, into these crops. The gene enables the crops to produce toxins which kill the insects that feed on the plant. Normally, tomatoes, as we can see from our diagrammatic representation, are harvested green, treated with ethylene gas for ripening. This has the disadvantage of that the tomatoes lost their flavor. In the genetically modified tomatoes, there is deletion of the gene responsible of enzyme production that leads to fruit softening. Hence, the tomatoes stay on the plant to ripen and realizing fuller development of the flavor without softening. That is what we call the genetic engineering, especially in the tomatoes. We have got another one. Attempts are being made to transfer the gene for nitrogen fixation from bacteria into cereal crops to yields without use of fertilizers. We can have another one whereby bovine somatotrophin is hormone that increases milk production in cows. The gene that controls production of this hormone, when transferred into bacteria, it makes the bacteria to produce the hormone in large quantities in a fermentation process. When this hormone is extracted from the bacteria and injected into a cow, it leads to increased number of cells in the mammary glands. The hormone has also been found to increase weight of beef cattle from around 10 to 15%. Agricultural biotechnology can assist farmers in improving their yields and overall quality of their produce. Through genetic modification, or what we call engineering, desirable genes can be transferred to crops while plants can be made to be more resistant to crops, insect pests, and other stresses. Genetic modification can also facilitate the development of crops with improved storage properties and quality characteristics. An example of this is the insect. Resistance Means for Africa, that is a project, actually it was launched in March 2002, which aims to develop stem borer resistant and locally adapted means for Kenya various agroecology zones by using both a conventional and biotechnology mediated methods, especially what we call biotechnology. Actually, that is one of the practical applications of genetic engineering. Now we are going to look at our second application of genetic engineering, which is the medicine. Now we are going to explain the genetic engineering in medicine, whereby we are saying various hormones are being produced by genetically modified organisms. We can have a strain of Escherichia coli has been made with synthesis of human insulin. Actually, these are insulin production, as you can see from our diagrammatic representation. The human gene that codes for insulin is transferred into the bacteria, thereby producing insulin that is purer and in large quantities. Previously, insulin was extracted from cows and pigs, that is the pig's pancreas, and was not pure. Such impurities have been the cause of many allergies and other disorders. A human somatotropic hormone for treatment of dwarfism is now extracted from genetically modified strain of Escherichia coli. These are the two applications of genetic engineering, though there are more which we shall discuss on our later lessons, but for this lesson we are discussing only two. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are required to identify two fields in which genetic engineering is applied. And to for more reference in this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 4, which is the 4th edition, the Nairobi Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this in our lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you can also subscribe to our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us as Elimu TV underscore Kenya. Let us subscribe for all these lessons to enjoy many more of our biology lessons. Thank you.